मॉर्फोलॉजिकल एक्सप्रेशन और एक्सटर्नल एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ ए जीन दैट इज नोन एज फिनोटाइप. सो वी कैन से दैट इट इज डिटरमाइंड बाय, हाउ इट कैन डिटरमाइन, सो इट इज डिटरमाइंड बाय डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ और डिफरेंट कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ एलील्स. ओके, सो it is determined by different types of alleles. Okay, so phenotype, that is morphological expression, determined by different type of alleles, or we can say different combination of alleles. Different combination of alleles. Okay, so this also you have to remember that different combination of alleles denotes what? Phenotype. Okay, now after phenotype, next term is genotype. So next we have to see genotype. Okay, phenotype, what I told, external. So genotype will be what? Internal. So internal constituents, what we can say? Complete genetic constitution. What we can say? Complete genetic constitution of an individual is known as genotype. So it is complete genetic constitution of an individual. Now this genotype is responsible to phenotype, means what the external characters you are seeing, it totally depends on what? Internal characters. And internal character is what? Genotypes. Okay, so this is genotype. Now next terms are there, now next terms is there, that is a homozygous. Now term is telling, homozygous means same. So when two alleles of a gene are similar, okay, what we can say homozygous? When two alleles of a gene are similar, so this condition is known as homozygous. When two alleles of a gene are similar, it is known as homozygous. Homo means same. Homozygous. Okay, it is homozygous. Now for example, what we can say if homozygous is there, for example if we are telling, so capital T, small t, okay, so this is homozygous condition. For example, capital T or small t, same type of alleles are there present in the gene, that is similar. Okay, and this denotes what? Tallness, means height, plant height we are seeing, we will see later. Now after homozygous, next term is there, that is heterozygous. Hetero means what we can say? When two alleles in a pair are different. Okay, so heterozygous. When two alleles in a pair of gene are different, Hetero means different. Okay. So this is what, when two alleles in a pair are in different, this condition what we can say. So this is the condition known as heterozygous. So we can say when two alleles in a pair of gene are different, it is known as heterozygous. What we can say? Heterozygous. These terms are very simple terms. These questions will not ask, but in deep, when we are going into that chapters, these terms are come. Okay, so these terms will come, so you have to understand previous, so that at that time you have no any confusion. Okay, now next term is dominant. Dominant. Now here, dominant means what? Expression. Okay, dominant means expression. So an allele that influences the appearance of phenotype. What we can say? An allele that influence the appearance of phenotype. Okay, what I told? An allele that influence the appearance of phenotype. Okay, even in presence of alternative allele, means recessive allele. Okay, so even in presence of alternative allele. Okay, so this condition, this is known as dominant. Means what? They are showing, they are expressing themselves by inhibiting others. This alternative is inhibiting. So this, which is inhibiting others, that is known as dominant. Okay. Now, for example, capital T. Okay. Now, next term. Here dominant is come, next term is a recessive. Now how we can define this recessive? An allele that influences the appearance of phenotype when other alternative character is not present. Means if small t is there, okay. So how we can define this recessive? An allele that influences the appearance of phenotype. Here we can write an allele that influences the appearance of phenotype. Okay, when this appearance will come only in presence of another identical allele. Okay, only in presence of another identical allele. Here this term is important, another identical. For example, small t. Okay, like here capital T was there, so here small t were there. In that case, this recessive condition will come. Okay, now next term is there, that is known as a genome. Now come on that. Next term is genome. Now, how we can define this genome? So, total set of genes present in haploid. What I am telling? Total set of genes present in haploid, or we can say haploid set of chromosome. Okay. So, total set of genes present in haploid. Haploid means N, set of chromosome. Okay, what is that? Total set of genes present in haploid set of chromosome. Okay, and inherited as unit means transfer from one generation to next generation. And inherited, so what we can say, and inherited as unit from where it will come? From parents to their offspring. To their offsprings. One time this question asked directly. They were asked, what do you mean by genome, or genome is? In medical exam that questions come. So one options were there. Total set of genes present in haploid set of chromosome. In that question, options were there. Okay. So what we can say, and inherited as unit from parents to their offsprings. So that is known as what? Genome. Now, next term is there, that is known as gene pool. So next, come on. Gene pool. Now, what do you mean by gene pool? So all the genotypes of an organism, okay, all the genotypes, please be on emphasis on genotype, all the genotypes of organism, okay, present in population. Okay, so what we can say, all the genotypes of all the organism, okay, all the genotypes of all the organism where it present in a population from the gene pool. Okay, so organism in a population known as, what is known as? Gene pool. Okay, so all the genotypes of all the organism present in population known as gene pool. Okay, so these are some terms that you have to remember. Okay, now some term is there that questions also already asked, that this term was given by. So one by one we will see. Okay, first we have to see that term allele. Who has given this term allele? So term allele was given by Batterson. Now come on. Term allele was given by Batterson. Okay, this term you have to remember. This term allele was given by Batterson. Now another term is there, homozygous, heterozygous. So these terms was given by Batterson and Saunders. So term homozygous and heterozygous was given by Batterson and Saunders. Okay, Batterson and Saunders. these terms you have to remember because questions are coming. Okay, direct questions are there. So term homozygous and heterozygous was given by Batson and Saunders. Now, recently we also seen some terms: genotype, phenotype, gene. Okay. So who has given these terms? Okay. So next we have to see. Term genotype, phenotype, gene, pure line. Pure line means what we can say, pure line means a homozygous condition which produces offspring. Okay, like capital T, small t, small t. Okay, so that is pure line. So term genotype, phenotype, gene, pure line, these terms were given by scientist Johansson. Was terms given by Johansson. Now these terms you have to remember. So term genotype, term phenotype, gene, pure line was given by Johansson. Okay, now this genetics start with classical genetics, old genetics. Okay, and old genetics having very much contribution that scientist name is Gregor Johann Mendel. So some history that is asking questions, so we have to know about that small. Okay, so first is scientist name is Gregor Johann Mendel. Okay, G.J. Mendel. Now this scientist is very high contribution to the genetics as a science, okay, as a study. Now first we have to see, it is known as father of genetics, father of genetics. Okay, now this is having a period, time period means from born to death. So he has born in 1822 and death in 1884. 1822 born and 1884 death. Okay, Gregor Johann Mendel. Now I have seen one question in JIPMER that they were asking questions that who, in which at which time, okay, what is the time duration that he has spent. Okay, so similarly you have to 1884 minus 1822, so 2 and 6, how much times he has spent? 62 years. Okay, 62 years that you have to remember. Okay, now he born on 22nd July. Okay, he born on 22nd July 1822. Okay, now this scientist worked on Pisum sativum, that is known as a garden pea. Worked on Pisum sativum. This is garden pea. This Pisum sativum, this Mendel has chosen for his experiment, Pisum sativum, garden pea. Okay, and he worked for 7 years. How much years? Worked 7 years, and years was 1858 to 1865 on garden P by some sativum. How much? This you have to remember. How many years he worked on? So 7 years, from 1858 to 1865. Okay. Now, what he does? He published his result. Okay. What he does? He published his result in Natural Science. One journal were there. That journal name was Natural Science Society of Brunn. Okay. He published his experimental result. Experimental results. Okay. Experimental results. Okay. In Natural Society. Okay. Natural Society of Brunn, or complete name was Natural Science Society of Brunn. So results in Natural Science Society of Brunn. Okay, this was the place. So Natural Science Society of Brunn, and that year was in 1865. In 1865. Okay. So this journal contains some paper. Many papers were there, and their paper name was asked in EMS. Okay. So that paper name was Experiments on Plant Hybridization. So we have to write. His experiments was published in and that paper was Experiments on Plant Hybridization. So his experiments was published in paper Experiments on Plants Hybridization. This paper you have to remember. Experiments on Plant Hybridization. And this was published in the fourth volume. Okay. So this was published in fourth volume of Proceedings of Natural Science Society of Brunn. Okay. So fourth volume of Proceedings of Natural Science Society of Brunn. Okay, this if you remember, that is okay. If you forget, that is also okay, no problem. But Experiments on Plant Hybridization and Natural Science Society of Brunn, you have to remember. Okay, and this was published in 1866. In 1866. Natural Science Society received in 1865, but published as a paper Experiments on Plants Hybridization in 1866. So here one important thing is there. Mendel first time applied statistics. One science is there. So Mendel was first to apply statistical analysis. Mendel was first to apply statistical analysis. This is what? This is mathematics. Okay, so Mendel was first to apply statistical analysis, okay, and logical science, okay, and logic. So these two comes here under where? Mathematics. He was basically mathematician. What was that? Mathematician, okay. He selected 14 true breeding pea plant varieties. He selected 14 true breeding pea plant varieties. That was 7 contrasting characters. Okay, 7 pair contrasting character, that was 14 true breeding pea plant varieties he chosen, okay, selected. Okay, now he died due to kidney failure. He died due to kidney failure in 1884. He died due to kidney failure in 1884. Okay, so their experiments didn't recognize to the scientific world till aliveness. Okay, till aliveness. After their death, these results were published with the help of other scientists. Okay, so we will see next. Now, one time questions I have seen that Mendel was the first to start a genetical experiments, or anyone else who already started. So yes, one scientist were there that was near to success. He not got success, but near to success. Okay, so before Mendel, that scientist name was J. Carl Ritter. Before Mendel, J. Carl Ritter. Okay, this name you have to remember. So J. Carl Ritter, I is also okay, and U is also okay. So both are okay. So before Mendel, J. Carl Ritter, he was the scientist who was near to success. Okay, so J. Carl Ritter has conducted hybridization experiment. Okay, so J. Carl Ritter has conducted hybridization experiment. Okay, so before Mendel, J. Carl Ritter has conducted what? Hybridization experiment on which plant? So on tobacco plant. On tobacco plant. Scientific name is Nicotiana tabacum. Botanical name is Nicotiana tabacum. Okay, this name you have to remember. Okay, so on which plant he done hybridization experiment? Tobacco plant. And reported that, first time he reported, and reported that progeny may resemble with their parent. And reported that progeny of a spring may resemble to their parent. He was the first who told. Okay. But now we have to come that why Mendel could not convince himself about his conclusion. Okay, he also, Mendel also given all the result, but many scientists were there who has some arguments that if it is true, so every plant should have to follow these rules, okay, should have to follow these results on the same, okay. So what happens, could not convince due to, because some scientists were there, he chosen a different, one different plant that was parthenogenetic, okay. So we have to see, Mendel could not convince, what I told, Mendel could not convince himself about his conclusion, convince himself about his experimental conclusions, what he conclusion given, okay, conclusions being universal, that all plants should have followed, okay, being universal. Why he cannot conclude? Because since he failed to produce the result, okay, since he failed to produce the results, okay, since he failed to produce the results on hawkweed, one plant were there on hawkweed, okay, on hawkweed, that is Hyrasium, okay, that is known as Hyrasium species, Hyrasium species. So one plant was there, this plant you have to remember, which was that hawkweed, and another was bean, and bean that was lub, okay, so and bean, but when later it was such, then it was found that it was naturally parthenogenetic plants, okay, and later found that these are parthenogenetic plant, means what, without fertilization they were developing, okay, and that's why this Mendel has not convinced himself about his experimental being universal. So plant's name are asking, so these two names you have to remember, one is hawkweed and one is bean. Why this result not came? Because that was parthenogenetic plant, okay, without fertilization, and in genetics all the terms, all the things are coming with fertilization, so without fertilization, that's why results not came in these plants, okay. Now on the basis of his experiment, Mendel has given some rules or postulates that we have to discuss now. On the basis of experiments Mendel's gave some postulates. Okay, what I told, on the basis of experiments, Mendel gave some postulates, formulate, postulate. So number one postulate was there, postulate one. Postulate one was there, principle of paired factors, means always genes present in paired form. Okay, so principle of paired factors. Paired factors. Okay, this factor was replaced